in our Tiburon studios in Orlando. This is the NFL on EA Sports, and this is Madden Ultimate Team. We're just about set to get started, and this ought to be a good one between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Pittsburgh Steelers. So with that, let's get you up to Heinz Field in Pittsburgh. Standing by for the call, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Happy to be on hand. I'm Brandon Godden with Charles Davis. And before we kick, partner, your keys to the game, please.
Well, my keys are on the defensive side of the ball for both teams. And the big one, making sure you avoid giving up the big play. These safeties are going to get tested all game long. Their job, keep the ball in front of them, tackle people, make them run extra plays in order to try and score.
Play action. It's Roethlisberger. Good for seven. It's third down. And so far, a very nice, methodical opening drive.
This has the feel of a scripted drive that they rehearsed perfectly all week long, and now they're executing it on game day.
Script looks good so far. To throw here, Roethlisberger. And this is going to be incomplete.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
They're going to go. Here's Connor, and he won't get there. They stop him a few yards short of the line to gain. They all throw in two positions. Khalil Mack there to make the stop. So now it's left in the hands of their defense to come up with an immediate stop.
And this is where you count on your stars on defense. Can they come up with a game-altering play here? Can they knife through into the backfield and pop the ball free? Can they make that type of a play that gives them another opportunity? And what do we say? One time out. Yep. But you get a second
one warning.
With a two-minute warning, so they've got to use those well.
Pick up waiting on first down. This is caught inside the five. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. They've got it first and goal as they search for what could be a game-sealing touchdown. It's first and goal, and a late touchdown at this stage could officially salt this one away. They're going to throw it here with Vic. And this is caught, and that could seal it. It's a touchdown.
Would be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face, and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Now the offense will stay out there. They're going to line up and try for two. Working out of the gun, Michael Vick. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. So trying to throw it in for 2 points, but he got home, brought him down.
They got home, which means it had to be good coverage. Just had nowhere to go with the ball. Technically, you're trying to throw quick hitters, quick slants, you know, maybe even a quick fade. Nothing was open. He ends up getting sacked.
The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. Down the field it will thus far. Here's first and 10 at the 25-yard line. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Out of the ball here to Brown. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. The completion good for 3 and it's second down. Second down, here's Roethlisberger. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Antonio Brown, the intended receiver. And it's third down.
It's never a bad idea to try and get it to Antonio Brown, but there must be a little bit of the Madden curse going off our cover athlete here. Hasn't been able to get that elite separation that we're used to seeing from him.
Now this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off near the 34.
It's been a game of punch-counterpunch, hasn't it? All throughout. But this time, the big swing was taken, and it didn't land. Nice play by them on defense.
The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. Four now, here's first and 10. They begin the drive with Johnson. Wow, amazing.
Make a miss.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 25 yards to pick up there, and also a first down.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know. Well conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
Forced out to his left. Got some real estate inside the 30. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 23 yards on the tuck and run.
Partner, it's often that man coverage is easier for a quarterback to run against. You get your receivers going downfield. Those guys are staying with him, and oftentimes they have their back to the quarterback, which opens up a lot of space and room, and they don't even know that he's taken off with it. What a big-time pickup on that play.
Flushed out right. That is caught at the second. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense as it comes with 1:04 left to go in the game. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. Solid opening drive so far. Now can they cash in first and goal? Despite the late lead, Nick's going to throw. Got his man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Jerry Rice, a 1-yard touchdown reception. And the Steelers take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive.
Is it okay if I break one of my rules, partner, which is to never call a game over until it's over? Because it certainly feels like it's over after that drive.
Yeah, that was spirit-crushing, wasn't it? And now you just kind of felt the air go out of the balloon.
So they were fighting so hard to stay in there, and they knew they had to stop them on that drive. But when they were unable to, I think you're exactly right. You can see them sag on their sideline. I think this one might just be over.
The extra point by Anderson, up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. They're down big here late. I don't know, maybe just one last drive here for Clyde.
Some people like to do that. I've never played for a guy once we were down huge. And someone said, Coach, what do you want to call? He just waved a hand like, who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time. But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. He's going to flip them out of here. Yeah, they'll break one tackle and then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. Give him 7 on the play, and it'll make it a second down. And he'll indeed get him to the line and spike it here to stop the clock. The Steelers on third down. They're hitting at just 30%, 3 for 10. This time it's 3rd and 3. For the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And he fires There's one that's intercepted. He's picked off just shy of midfield. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent. And now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
Comes the Steeler offense now, ready to see what they can do here. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
It's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel-down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now, to put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there. Here, and I really don't want to, because the old school in me is not happy about this score this late, not necessary. But this is Madden, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is how it works.
Rub it in. Have a day.
I mean, what does it matter? These guys who are playing in this game, there are no feelings
exactly.
There.
They don't have to face the guy. Well, they might if they're in the same room going head to head.
But that's
the
about
virtual
it.
Guys on the screen don't have to face each other after this one.
In that case, run it up.
Now to try to add the extra point, the lefty Anderson. Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point lines up successful. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. The Steelers defense, we watch them get set to go. They've got the victory in sight. You've been in this spot before back in your playing days. How nice is it to go out there pretty much knowing this is a victory?
It's beyond nice. It's what you build for each and every week that you're getting ready to play. And that's a tough, long week of practice. And to be able to turn it into a win and be able to enjoy it, yeah, that's why you play.
Now they'll just be looking here for one final stop in the waning moments. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Second and 10, it's Roethlisberger once more. The ball popped in the air, intercepted. Picked off by Ryan Shazier. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line. Facing this fourth quarter deficit, felt like they had to throw the ball around the other side. They were ready.
No doubt about it, they're playing situational football. They look at the clock, they know the lead that they have, and all they're doing is playing pass on every down.
Playing the pass, picking it off, and that big time in the driver's seat. Vic's going to take a knee, and that should just about do it. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win, it's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. What were they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator,